I think it is pretty safe to say that over these past 4 years here at C to E, I have done quite a bit of changing, just like the rest of you. And before you say, "What do you mean? I'm still me, I haven't changed," just think about it. Are any of us really the same person that we were in middle school? I would hope not. That might be a bigger issue here. But anyway, high school changes all of us. Sometimes for the better, sometimes not. But as for me, I would like to think that these changes were for the better. And today, for my last lecture, I would like to share a few of these changes and how they came about. The first change has to do with how I live my life. If any of you know me well, you would know that I'm a people pleaser. I like to make everyone else happy, even if that means sacrificing my own happiness. On top of being a people pleaser, I'm a perfectionist. I want to be performing at the best of my ability and then some. Not only did I feel pressure from my parents, friends, coaches, and teachers, but I also put a tremendous amount of stress on myself. I felt that if I did not perform well at whatever it is I was doing, I would disappoint everyone around me. The combination of these things really started taking a toll on me at the end of freshman year. And long story short, I was diagnosed with a stress-induced anxiety disorder that summer. But I feel like this is kind of a blessing in disguise for me. After this diagnosis, I started reflecting on how I was living my life, and I realized that I was not living for myself. I was living for everyone around me. I was living for the approval of my parents and the acceptance of my friends. I was doing whatever I thought everyone else wanted from me, but this is no way to live your life. After I found out about my anxiety, I started living my life for myself and doing what makes me happy, and in turn, I felt happier and I didn't have nearly as many problems with my anxiety as I did before. I realized that I am the only one that is going to have to face the consequences of the decisions that I make. Not my mom, my friends, my coaches, or teachers. Just me. So why should I stress out about what someone else will think when it isn't going to affect them at all? The grade I get on my math test has nothing to do with my parents or friends. It's my grade and it's my life. There's only one thing that you take away from this. It should be do what makes you happy. It's your life, not your parents, friends, or anyone else's. It's your life, so live it for you. The second change has to do with who I have surrounded myself with these past 4 years. My freshman year, I didn't have many friends at all, and the ones I had weren't good friends. The girls that I was friends with were really just using me. This sounds really bad, but they were only friends with me because I let them copy my homework every day. I was still in that awkward, shy stage in my life, and honestly, I was just happy that I had someone to sit with at lunch and talk to occasionally. I wasn't the type to go up to someone and start a conversation. I just wanted to lay low and get through high school as quickly and smoothly as possible. But all that changed sophomore year when I met the people that I would call my best friends for the remainder of my high school career. After hanging out with them a few times, I wasn't the same shy girl, and I wasn't scared to talk to people. They may not realize this, but they helped me break out of my shell and helped me become the person that I am today. This group of people genuinely likes me for me, and not just for my homework. They support me in my decisions, and they let me be myself. I know that they are always there for me, just like I am there for them. They truly are the best friends that I could ask for, and I don't know where or who I would be without them. There are those people that I know I will never talk to or see again after we walk across that stage and get our diplomas, but not them. Things will definitely be different next year, but I know that I will still try to keep in contact with them throughout college and maybe for the rest of our lives. And even if we don't, I just want to say thank you to all the people that helped make my high school career here at Butler an enjoyable one. You all helped me become the person I am today, and for that, I'm eternally grateful. I'd like to wrap things up with a short poem I found. 2006. It's fascinating how we're taught that home is this tangible place, the most simply defined of terms. It's a house, a postcode, a country, and yet sometimes home cannot be described by a street number. Sometimes it's a face, a voice, a laugh more honest and familiar than any truth you've ever known. We're taught that in its most literal sense, home is where we live and grow. But one day, in the silence that follows nostalgic stories and subsequent laughter, you may realize that you never did more living or growing than when you had certain people by your side. And suddenly, you're home.